Afternoon, students, and welcome to today's science class. We human beings are heterotrophs, and we derive our nutrition either from plants or animals. And this process of obtaining nutrition involves a series of steps, including the digestion process. But this process of digestion or the breaking down of food into simpler substances is not enough. Our body cells need to be provided with the nutrients obtained from this food. Since we human beings are multicellular animals, we consist of millions and billions of cells. So, how do this transport of nutrients, water, and other minerals takes place in the body? As well as, how does the removal of waste products which are produced by the cells takes place? This takes place with the help of a very important component of the circulatory system called as the blood. The blood, it is a fluid connective tissue, and it provides the cells with the nutrients and the useful materials needed. Also, it takes away the waste product which is produced by the cells, but this blood is pumped with a very important organ of the human body called as the heart. Now, so today we will be dealing with a very important topic, a very important organ of the human body called as the heart. The heart, it is a muscular organ and it beats continuously and rhythmically throughout the life of an organism from birth till the death of an organism. And it is beating continuously without stopping. So, it is an involuntary organ and does not work according to our will. Now, where is this heart located? What is the place where it is situated? So, a heart is situated in the chest cavity, slightly tilted to the left. Now, what is the size and the shape? The heart, it is a muscular organ. And if we close our fist, this is called as the clenched fist. So, the size of the heart is approximately the same as the size of our clenched fist. Now, what is the shape of the heart? This heart is roughly triangular in shape. Okay, so now we will be dealing with what is the structure of the cell? Heart. The heart, it is a muscular organ and it is protected by a double layered membrane called as the pericardium. Our heart, it is divided into the left part and the right part with the help of a partition called as the septum, and this septum is called as the wall partition. The right side of the heart is called as the right heart, while the left side of the heart is often referred to as the left heart. Okay, so the left side will be left heart and the right side will be the right heart. Okay, so in human beings, the heart, it is divided into four chambers. That is, the heart is four-chambered heart in human beings. But it is not the case in all the living organisms. Just like amphibians, reptiles, they have only three-chambered heart. That is, the two atrium and the one ventricle. Okay, in the fish, the heart is only two-chambered. That is, the one atrium and the one ventricle. Okay, so those organisms in which two or three chambered heart is present are the cold blooded animals, and they do not need to maintain their body temperature, which means not much energy is spent in maintaining their body temperature. So in these cold blooded animals, the mixing of oxygenated, which means the oxygen containing blood, and the deoxygenated, that is the carbon dioxide containing blood, takes place, and not sufficient amount of energy is produced in comparison to the energy produced in four-chambered heart. So what do you mean by four-chambered heart? I have been talking about it so long. What is meant by four-chambered heart? Okay, this is the four-chambered heart consisting of two atria and the two ventricles respectively. The human heart, it consists of left atrium and the right atrium, which is the upper part, and the left ventricle and the right ventricle, which is the lower part. Now, both of this atrium, they are receiving the blood from the two main veins called as the pulmonary veins and the vena cava. Okay, but the two ventricles, they are supplying the blood to all the body parts as well as the lungs. Now, this left atrium, it is connected to the left ventricle with the help of a wall called as the V1 wall. While the left atrium, where the right atrium, it is connected to the right ventricle with the help of another wall which is called as the V2 wall. Now, these two walls are called as the inlet walls because they are allowing the blood to flow inside the heart. Okay, now the wall which is present between the left atrium or the wall which is present or connects the left atrium to the left ventricle is called as the bicuspid wall. Why it is called the bicuspid wall? Because it consists of two cusps. Okay, now the wall which connects the right atrium to the right ventricle is called as the tricuspid wall because it consists of three cusps. Okay, now there are another two set of valves which are called as the V1 wall and the V3 wall. These two valves are called as the outlet valves. Why these two valves are called as the outlet valves? Because they are supplying the blood outside either to the lungs or add to the main artery, that is the aorta. Okay, so now this heart, it consists of a series of supply chain and it consists of called as the capillaries, arteries and the veins. Okay, which we will be discussing later when we will be dealing about how the process of circulation takes place. So this heart is a very important organ and it helps in the circulation. The circulation which is taking place in our body is called as the double circulation process. Okay, so with the help of this organ, with the help of this heart, the blood supplies the nutrients to each and every cell of the body and also the waste material such as the carbon dioxide is taken away from the heart. So this was all about the most important organ called as the heart. In the next topic, we will be dealing with how the process of circulation takes place. Thank you. Till then, have a nice day. Thank you. Thanks for watching.